again. Thank you very much.
Excellent. I think it will be a good interview. You had a conference in Paris today with quite a few people. I don't know how many were there, but it was quite interesting.
Luminaries in the industry.
And one of the best things was the discussion about calibration, HD, everything, which are the main interesting point for you. So let's start maybe by HD.
Well, the coming of HD.
The coming of HD.
The coming of HD to Europe, because it is coming, and I will tell you, it really is coming. You can expect it. The coming of HD is only going to be as successful as the consuming audience perceives it. And if the consuming audience isn't aware that they have a responsibility to the signal, if they have a responsibility to the quality that they see, they might not appreciate what HD is capable of delivering. So my coming here to Paris was an attempt to say, in the past, you've been told that PAL is good enough, and that if you don't make an effort to see HD for what it's actually capable of doing, you might actually believe that PAL is good enough. But on the other hand, if you see HD for what it's really capable of doing, you'll never want to go back to PAL again. You'll never want to watch anything in PAL. You will just say, HD or nothing.
All right, but HD is not plug and play.
Oh, that's absolutely a correct statement. That with all the digital technology and all of the requirements for display calibration, as an example, high definition requires a level of expertise in order to get it right. And one of the things that I would like to believe that the consumer is sophisticated enough to acknowledge is that it's much easier to hire somebody who knows what they're doing and just help them get it right. There are certainly companies who are capable of not only calibrating the systems and setting them up, but integrating them so that everything works properly, so that you can truly have a touch panel remote control and everything functions. But getting it to that level does require outside expertise. The reality is appreciating PAL for what it's worth requires a similar expertise. And that as much as everybody says that PAL is good enough, PAL is actually quite good. Not that HD isn't a lot better, but sometimes people would see more out of even PAL if they would take the time to get the expertise in and get it done right.
So what can a consumer expect? I mean, he just want to buy his HD TV set, then plug it in himself and call for help, installers, or expect a full service, or what's the procedure?
Certainly, on a simple level, if you're buying a high definition display, and for the time being, before high definition is available, getting somebody in to set up that display to maximize its capability is one thing. But even before buying this display, there are multiple things to be considered. Number one, you've got to start by looking at some displays that claim to be HD ready are not HD ready, that they truly aren't capable of producing the kind of quality.
Even with the HD ready logo?
And I definitely believe that. That was part of the conference today, is that just because it has an HD-ready logo, and while I don't know specifically what's going on here in Europe, we had HD-DVD-compatible TV sets in the United States. And looking at those sets, they weren't truly HD-TV-compatible. So if you're just planning on buying a system, I actually think it's important to ask somebody who knows what they're doing when you step into this market. And I don't necessarily believe all the retailers, the general purpose retailers, know a lot about high definition. In fact, if you go in and ask retailers here in Paris, the standard shop that is selling HD sets, I'd be willing to bet if you start asking them some sophisticated questions, as an example, does it have an independent decoder for high definition than standard definition? If you ask that simple question, I'd be willing to bet that they wouldn't have a clue what you were talking about, let alone whether any one of the sets have a special high definition decoder, which of course is required in order to get a correct picture. So it's to do a good job of HD, to see what it's worth, I think is going to require going to a specialist, a specialty retailer, someone who knows what they're doing in putting it together.
All right. The HD DVD will come soon in Europe. I mean, it's the first products are announced for the end of the year, probably November. They already been introduced in the United States a month or 2 months ago, something like that. Mm-hmm. What would have changed in the business and HD? And
the irony for Europe of HD DVD coming and HD DVD coming at the time that terrestrial broadcast and satellite broadcast is just getting started is that HD DVD has a potential of being vastly superior to anything that the broadcasters or the terrestrial services can provide. So it's exciting from that standpoint. It's more exciting in our American market, where we're already conditioned to HD DVD or HD TV being a wow product, it being a fantastic product. I mean, none of us would ever watch Desperate Housewives in standard definition once we've seen it in high definition. But HD DVD has a potential for delivering picture quality that is vastly superior to anything we believe the broadcasters are going to be able to deliver in the near future. So that the reality is, in HD DVD, is that the picture quality will be a lot better than anything the broadcasters are going to provide. So if you see a movie on broadcast, you're still going to want to go out and buy it in HD DVD, because the picture you will get from it will be better than what you saw in the broadcast.
All right. Blu-ray will come a bit later. I mean, it's not decided 100% right now, but we don't know exactly when it will be disclosed. What is your position? What do you think about that?
I get myself in a lot of trouble, and I will tell you, because I like getting myself in trouble. It is my personal belief that Blu-ray is all about greed. That there are a lot of things that have gone on in the discussion of the introduction. Obviously, Blu-ray isn't here yet. But as an example, Sony has said that they're going to be doing MPEG-2 rather than the newer codecs, either the advanced video codec, which was picked here in Europe for distribution of high definition, or the Microsoft, it's actually a SMPTE standardized VC1 codec. Both of those codecs have superior capability over MPEG-2. And the fact that Sony has said that they're going to introduce all of their first versions of Blu-ray in MPEG-2, and the fact that they've claimed that MPEG-2 is easily the equal or even better, says that they haven't been looking at it in a manner in which they can see it. Because I've been doing demonstrations now for over a year of what MPEG-2 looks like versus VC1. And in all cases, in audiences that I do it for, no one misses the differences between MPEG-2 and VC1, as an example. I have not, incidentally, I will qualify, I have not done the H.264 demonstrations, because that isn't quite as far along in technology as VC1. And I can get really good encodes of VC1 where I've not been able to get that out of H.264. But the fact that a company would claim that something we can prove is inferior, the fact that they would claim that it would be superior, says there must be another motivation, and or they're looking at it at a level where they can't see the difference.
All right. Thank you very much, and hope that the best will win. Qualitatively, I mean.
We certainly would like to believe that quality can win over. And that is something the consumer is going to determine. If they take the responsibility to create displays that will show them the quality difference, then they'll pick quality. And that's going to require the kind of help that we've been talking about.
So we must train consumers.
We must train consumers. And I congratulate you on being a part of that effort.
Thank you very much. Good evening.
Thank you.